and disharmony in the Republican Party just days before the general elections. At a recent GOP village meeting, a fiery speech by Governor Eddie Calvo ignited one Democrat lawmaker to defend some Republican senators on social media. Here's more.
You ain't seen nothing yet. Yeah. Nothing yet.
It was during a GOP village meeting this weekend when Governor Eddie Calvo delivered a fiery speech that at least one Democrat lawmaker says excludes certain members of his own party as retribution for not supporting a particular piece of legislation.
But when it comes time for action, that is you see the true heart and the true soul of our Republican leaders. Thank you, Frank Boss. Thank you, Tony Adda. Thank you, Brad McCready. Thank you, Tommy Morrison. Did I forget any of our incumbent senators? No, I think I remembered every single one.
Senator Sinicholas took to Facebook after the meeting to point out that Governor Calvo intentionally left out Senators Mary Torres and Jim Espaldon in his speech. Sinicholas says, quote, Senator Mary Torres and Senator Jim Espaldon were not even acknowledged, all in retribution for them not supporting more borrowing, end quote. According to Sinicholas, Torres was only able to speak at the event after her brother, former Governor Felix Camacho, the GOP candidate for Congress, yielded some of his time to give her the floor. While on the floor, Senator Torres said that disagreement within the party is not a sign of absolute disunity.
Regardless of whether we are able to say to the other, excuse me, but I would like to also have a point of view. That's really what it is. It's not about being disrespectful, because we all have to rely on each other. There's a phrase that says disunity, debate is not disunity. It is the essence of democracy.
Sinicholas, meanwhile, continued his criticism of the Republican Party through social media while praising Senator Torres. Camacho endorsed Sinicholas during his first run in the legislature. In his Facebook post, Sinicholas said, quote, I will not mince words. There is too much at stake. We have today's senators you have elected, a number of Republicans, and even a few Democrats who 9 times out of 10 will only vote in line with how they are expected to vote, according to the governor. Whoever does not gets targeted, attacked, and left out. Those who comply get praised and supported. Sinicholas alleges that Torres and Espaldon were specifically left out because they did not fall in line with the rest of the Republicans in supporting Brant McCready's Bill 390, which proposes to borrow a $100 million Series E bond that Senator McCready says would ensure that taxpayers receive their refunds in days instead of months.
Governor Calvo, Senator Torres, and Senator Sinicholas were all unavailable for comment as of news time. You can see more of the videos online at our website at pacificnewscenter.com.